Thing. Wait, let me back up a little bit more. We got people in the front row. Please stand as we begin our worship. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the name which we baptize. What is baptism? It is water used according to God's command and connected with God's word. What gifts does baptism grant? It brings about forgiveness of sins, redeems from death, and gives eternal salvation to all who believe. How can water do such great things? The water does not do this alone, but the word of God with and alongside of the water and faith. This is a grace-filled water of life, a bath of new birth in the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
I give thanks to you, Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have graciously protected me today. I ask you to forgive me all my sins, where I have done wrong, and graciously to protect me tonight. Into your hands I commend myself, my body, my soul, and all that is mine. Let your holy angel be with me, so that the wicked foe may have no power over me. Amen.
Please be seated for the readings. Our first reading is from Isaiah chapter 60. Instead of bronze, I will bring gold. Instead of iron, I will bring silver. Instead of wood, bronze. Instead of stone, iron. I will appoint peace as your overseer and righteousness as your taskmaster. Violence shall no more be heard in your land, devastation or destruction within your borders. You shall call your walls salvation and your gates praise. The sun shall no longer be your light by day, nor for brightness shall the moon give light to you by night. But the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Your sun shall no more go down, or your moon withdraw itself. For the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of mourning shall be ended. For your people shall all be righteous, and they shall possess the land forever. They are the shoot that I planted, the work of my hands, so that I may be glorified. The least of them shall become a clan, and the smallest one a mighty nation. I am the Lord. And it's time I will accomplish it quickly. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading comes from St. Matthew, the 9th chapter. As Jesus went on from there, two blind men followed him, crying loudly, "Have mercy on us, son of David." When he entered the house, the blind men came to him, and Jesus said to them, "Do you believe that I am able to do this?" They said to him, "Yes, Lord." Then Jesus touched their eyes and said, "According to your faith, let it be done to you." And their eyes were opened. Then Jesus sternly ordered them, "See that no one knows of this." But they went away and spread news about him throughout the district. After they had gone away, a demoniac who was mute was brought to him. And when the demon had been cast out, the one who had been mute spoke. And the crowds were amazed and said, "Never has anything like this been seen in Israel." But the Pharisee said, "By the ruler of demons, he casts out the demons." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Join me. I have the joy of Jesus down in my heart. Down in my heart. Down in my heart. I've got the joy of Jesus down in my heart. Down in my heart to stay. Where did you discover joy today in your family conversations? Any joy in your talking? I believe we did with the Shack conversation. The movie and the book, The Shack. Biscotti. Now that's joy. Aha, honoring your mother is joyful. Joy, where else did you find it in your conversations? Music? celebrating an anniversary today. Joy. It's all around us, isn't it? Now, in the gospel text that Angela shared with us, did you notice who didn't have joy? Jesus heals two blind men and a man who's mute. So they have joy. They express it and show it. Those who believe in Jesus, they have joy. That's good news that Jesus is healing. Who did not have joy? Who? The Pharisees. Yeah. There's always someone who refuses to accept the gift of God's joy. Don't be that someone. When I'm being that someone, don't let me get away with it. How about it? As brothers and sisters, honoring the joy that God gives us, how about we not let one another get away with it? Now, you can't be happy and smiling and joy-filled all the time. But even when we're not, we can be held accountable. And we can bring it up in love. Now, this joy is not generated from nothing. At the beginning of the service, we looked at the baptism and how God's grace is connected to us, washing us, renewing us. And our first time together was about faith and trusting God. A direct, a specific faith, trust in the grace that God has given us. It's a very specific trust that we have for God. That He makes good on His word. That when He says you're forgiven, you're forgiven. When He says you're renewed, you're renewed. And to believe and trust in that is the source of the confidence and knowledge, knowing that there's a relationship, a viable, real, eternal relationship with God. And from that, we can't help to have joy. So it grows out of faith. It grows out of knowing and understanding and believing in God's unconditional love for us. Joy is a natural sprout. And so in the first reading from the 60th chapter of Isaiah, we heard an ordinary metal being turned into an extraordinary precious metal. That's you, my friends. That's you. And when I don't treat you like you're a precious metal, you need to hold me accountable. When you don't treat one another as being precious in the hands of God, you're no longer an ordinary human being. You're extraordinary, born of this water, of this grace, of this new life that leads to joy. And we need to remind one another in a good way and share with one another in good ways of how this joy of God is growing. And in one part of that text from the 60th chapter of Isaiah, it's just a small little sprout. And you can imagine just ripping that small little sprout up, how vulnerable it is. But yet it is protected. And it grows, and it's mighty, and it's big. And that's from that same text. So I look forward to continuing in this Lenten journey as we rejoice in the shadow of death, pain, brokenness, and destruction. Because our faith in the grace of Jesus Christ leads us to a joy-filled resurrection. So we thank you, Lord, for discovering in us what is precious and renewing us in your presence. Amen. I've got the joy of Jesus down in my heart.
Down in my heart. Down in my heart.
I've got the joy of Jesus down in my heart. Down in my heart to stay. And it goes on. Now, for our prayers, you may start at the Garden of Gethsemane If you'd like to start at the garden by looking at the Bible text, you certainly may. You don't even have to get up. If you'd like to journey and come over here and spend a little time with what it's like to be in a garden of anxiety and overwhelmed with all of that's before you, just spend a little time here at the garden. You're welcome to go clockwise from pillar to pillar. There are 14 stations, each one representing and depicting and taking us to a time in Jesus' life, ranging from the Garden of Gethsemane to Jesus at the tomb. So that will be our prayers. And after a certain amount of time, we'll get back together and pray the Lord's Prayer. Go forth in prayer. Thank you. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Please stand. God, our provider, you have not fed us with bread alone, but with words of grace and life. Bless us in these your gifts, which we receive from your bounty. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. go forth to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.